Hello friends and welcome to StudyIQ. My name is Dr. Mahipal Singh Rathod and in this video, I'm going to discuss the current affairs, daily current affairs MCQs for 14 June 2019. If you are taking notes of these videos, it is very well and good. But if you want to download the PDF, then you can download it here from my Facebook page. And if you're not using Facebook, then you can follow me on Telegram here at Mahipal Rathod. That's the name of the channel. StudyIQ has launched its pendrive and tablet courses for UPSC aspirants. If you are preparing for 2020 UPSC Civil Services exam, so you can prepare using our pendrive courses where there's complete coverage of the vast syllabus of UPSC. We provide daily current affairs updates via our channel as well as special videos for the pendrive buyers. Then you can learn according to your own pace. You can watch lectures according to your own speed. You'll be taught by the top faculties in India and the course will cost you only ₹625 per month. For more details, you can visit our website studyiq.com. Starting with the first question today, who has won the 54th Gyanpeeth Award? Who was awarded the 54th Gyanpeeth Award? So this is Amitav Ghosh. So Amitav Ghosh, he's a renowned author and he has been awarded for Indian literature and he's writing in English language. Okay, so he's the first English writer to win the Gyanpeeth Award. He was presented the award by former governor of West Bengal, Mr. Gopal Krishna Gandhi. Can you name a famous book of Amitav Ghosh in the comments? If you can name two, it is very well. If you can, at least try to write one book written by Amitav Ghosh in the comment section. Question number two, International Albinism Awareness Day was observed on 13th of June. That was yesterday. Albinism is a medical condition in which the body does not produce the pigment called melanin. So in the absence of melanin pigment, which gives the coloration, so you see this dark color here, this is because of melanin pigment. So all the people have some amount of melanin, some have it more, some have it less, that gives you the color of your skin. So if you have melanin pigment, you are protected against the harmful UV radiation of the sun. But in people with albinism, there is no melanin pigment. It is not formed in the body. So you can see this child here has no melanin pigment in his skin. So if this is exposed to sun, it can lead to many complications. So you have to avoid the sun if you have albinism, and that is a very big problem because it is very hard to avoid the sun. You cannot go outside, you have to cover your body completely. And for this, International Albinism Awareness Day for this condition has been observed on 13 June, and the theme for this year was Still Standing Strong. So you can write down the theme if you want, Still Standing Strong. Question number three, name of Malaysia badminton legend who announced retirement after battle with cancer. So it is Lee Chong Wee. Lee Chong Wee has called retirement after almost 18 years of a long career, illustrious career. And Lee Chong Wee was famous because he was finalist in World Series, Olympics many times, but he could not win a World Championship or the Olympic gold medal. He did win the bronze three times, but he could never win the gold or he could never win the World Championship as well. But he has had a fabulous career of 18 years, more than 18 years, and he called it quits because of his battle with cancer. Lee Chong Wee. Question number 4. India is planning to launch its own space station by which year? So the answer to this is 2030. Yesterday, ISRO announced, ISRO chief K Sivan is the chief of ISRO right now. So he announced that India will be undertaking a mission to launch its own space station by 2030. So first we will be having the Gaganyaan mission in which we will place a man in the space. And later on, as an extension of that Gaganyaan mission only, in the next 11 years, we will have our own space station. So that space station will be around 20 tons in weight and it will be used to conduct microgravity experiments. So it will be used to conduct microgravity because gravity in space is very less as compared to the ground in the orbit. So they will conduct microgravity experiments and it will be able to accommodate astronauts or gaganauts for 15 to 20 days. Main thing that was announced was that we will not be collaborating with any other country for this space station. As of now, there is International Space Station that was launched by the combined efforts of US, Russia and other countries, and one space station that was launched by China. So apart from these two, no one has a space station. So India will be having its own space station in the next 3 years. So it's a very important project for the space program of India. Question number 5. Name the Indian Air Force aircraft which was crashed in Arunachal Pradesh and all 13 people on board were declared dead 2 days back. The debris of that aeroplane was found, and yesterday when the Air Force personnel went on ground, they found that no one survived the crash. So that aeroplane was Antonov 32, AN-32, and AN-32 is a workhorse of the Indian Air Force. We have more than 100 AN-32. This is mainly used for transportation. Even the Indian Navy uses this, but it is very old. It is of Russian make and the design is almost 40 years old. It was designed in the 1970s and we got majority of the plane in the 80s and the 90s. So all the planes that we are using in the Air Force right now are at least 30 years old. So this is a big problem for Indian Air Force right now. The Antonov 32 fleet is aging very fast and we need a big cache of transport plane. We need a big supply of transport planes very soon. So let's see what Indian Air Force is going to do in the next 4 or 5 years. Which two nations have reaffirmed a joint commitment to fight against terrorism? So these two nations are UAE and Germany, United Arab Emirates and Germany. They have said that they will be fighting terrorism at both regional and international levels and they will be cooperating and rallying their counter-terrorism efforts together. They will be sharing information, they will be sharing expertise, and also will be sharing training modules and capacity building. What is the name of the vice chairman of Wave Group who was arrested in a fraud case at Delhi Airport? So this is Mr. Monty Chadda. So Monty Chadda is not his actual name. His full name is Manpreet Singh Chadda, but he is called mostly Monty by everyone. So Monty Chadda is the CEO of the Wave Group. He is the head of the Wave Group, which has a lot of construction activities going on all around Delhi and NCR region. If you live in Delhi NCR, you might have seen a Wave Mall at least someplace. But he has been arrested by the Economic Offences Wing of the police because he was trying to flee the country. He was trying to go to Thailand, and it has alleged that he has duped people of 100 crore rupees, more than 100 crore rupees. He has duped people in his various construction projects. So he was arrested yesterday. Question number 8. The government has reduced the total rate of contribution towards the employee state insurance scheme to what percentage? So it was earlier 6.5. It has been reduced to 4.0. So they have reduced it to 4.0. Earlier it was 6.5. Why it is reduced? So that compliance will increase. It is aimed at formalizing India's informal workforce. And where is ESI necessary? According to the ESI Act of 1948, if you have an organization with more than 10 employees, then they are drawing a salary of up to 21,000, then you have to contribute to ESI. It is mandatory that you have to contribute to employee state insurance. So ESI will provide for medical, cash, maternity, disability and other benefits to the people who are insured under this scheme. So it is a kind of medical insurance as well as insurance for disabilities and other benefits. So earlier it was 6.5%. Now this has been reduced to 4%. So what will happen? Compliance will increase. More and more companies, more and more organizations will be brought under this ESIC scheme. Question number 9. What is the rank of India in terms of FDI inflow in the year 2018 as per UNCTAD World Investment Report 2019? First of all, do you know the full form of UNCTAD, also called as UNCTAD? So this is United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. So United Nations Conference on Trade and Development has brought this report on FDI inflow, and India's position in this is 10th. Remember, the position of India is 10th. Number one is USA. And how much amount, what is the amount of FDI inflows into India? It is $42 billion. Okay, it is $42 billion. In the previous year, it was $40 billion. So we have seen an increase of 6%. And the problem right now is that in the entire world, FDIs are reducing. The amount of FDI inflows and around the world globally are decreasing, but India has seen a marginal increase of 6%. Now tell me one thing in the comment section: where is the headquarter of this organization? Where is the headquarter of this UN organization? Tell me in the comment section. Veteran poet Padavila Rameshan, who passed away recently, hailed from which state? So he was from Kerala, and he was the recipient of the Kerala Sahitya Academy Award for his contribution to Malayalam poetry. He wrote in Malayalam and he passed away at the age of 83 recently. Center has directed banks to issue Kisan credit cards within what time frame of submitting application? So government has now said that the banks have to issue within 2 weeks. So within 2 weeks, answer is D, 2 weeks. What is KCC? Kisan credit card. It is often abbreviated as KCC. See, KCC is a kind of loan. Normally farm loans are given at an interest rate of 9%, but under the KCC scheme, government will provide a subsidy of 2%. So instead of 9%, under the KCC scheme, the farmers will get a loan at the 7% interest rate. If the loan is up to 3 lakh rupees, then it increases slightly up to, then it increases little by little. As you go higher, the interest rate is also more, but it is most beneficial for small farmers. So you don't need to take money. If you are a farmer, you don't need to take money every time again and again you need money. You directly have a credit facility. As and when you want, you can withdraw the money, use it for your agricultural activity, and then give the money back to the bank. So it is like a existing credit line that mostly businesses have, but under the KCC scheme, even the farmers have a credit line under the KCC scheme. And the interest is also very low. It is only 7%. So currently there are 6.95 crores active KCC in India, in which crop loans are given at a subsidized rate. But the problem is that mostly farmers are complaining that banks do not give them the KCC. Even if they apply, it takes a long time. They will have some roadblocks in the process. So now the government has given the guideline that you have to give the KCC within 2 weeks of applying. The GSM, Global Securities Market Green, which is a platform for trading in green bonds, has been launched by, the answer is INX. What is INX? It is India International Exchange. The India International Exchange. This INX is owned by the Bombay Stock Exchange, by BSE. So it is a undertaking of the BSE, and INX has launched an exclusive platform for trading in green bonds. So remember, very important, green bonds. In green bonds, there will be trading happening on this global securities market on GSM. So it went live on 12th of June, and the first companies to be listed were Adani Green Energy. Write this down as well if you want. Adani Green Energy Limited was the first company which was listed on this GSM platform. Which of these banks has topped the Forbes World's Largest Public Companies 2000 list? So the largest company is Industrial and Commercial Bank of China Limited, ICBC. This is the largest public company on the Forbes 2000 list. And JP Morgan Chase is on second. So JP Morgan is on number two. The China Construction Bank is on number three. China Construction Bank is on number three. Out of 2000, how many companies are there from India? There are only 57 companies out of 2000 which are from India. And the highest ranked Indian company is Reliance. So Reliance is at number 71. Reliance Industries is at 71. And HDFC Bank is at 209. So these are the ranks of the Indian companies. If you want, you can remember these, but just remember number one is Industrial and Commercial Bank of China Limited. India will launch its first mission to study the sun named Aditya L1 in which year? The answer is 2020. So next year, Aditya L1 will be launched. It will be the first mission by India to study the sun. So it will observe the solar corona of the sun, and it will keep a permanent eye on the sun without any disturbance. So they will insert it into an halo orbit, and that point where they will be keeping it will be called Lagrangian point. Lagrangian point 1, that is why this is called Aditya L1. L is for Lagrangian. So this is the point in the orbit where this will be inserted. So this is the Aditya L1 mission in 2020. Can you tell me the distance between Earth and the Sun? Write it down in kilometers. What is the distance between Earth and Sun? Politician Rajnath Singh Surya, who passed away recently, was a former member of Rajya Sabha from which state? Was he from Rajasthan, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh or Jharkhand? He was from Uttar Pradesh. Now don't confuse him with Mr. Rajnath Singh. He is alive and well. So this is Rajnath Singh Surya. So he used to be a Rajya Sabha member. Now he was in news because when he died, he decided to donate his body to the medical college. So his body will be given to the medical college in Lucknow, that is the King George Medical University, the KGM Medical College. And this is a noble deed that he has donated his body for medical research purposes. 2019 Shanghai Cooperation Organization Summit is being held in which country? So this is being held in country Kyrgyzstan. Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Tell me the capital of Kyrgyzstan. Okay, this is the place where the summit is being held. That is the capital. Okay, leave it. I'll only tell you it is Bishkek. This was in news because of other reasons as well. Because India wanted the plane of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to fly over Pakistan. As you know, Pakistan has stopped its airspace. Indian planes are not coming via the airspace of Pakistan. But we sought a special permission. But later on, India did not ask for the permission. We decided to go via other route. The plane flew over Iran and then went to Bishkek to take part in this summit at Kyrgyzstan. Shanghai Cooperation Organization. This is the second summit that India is attending after becoming a full-time member of SCO. Who are the members of SCO? It is China, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, Russia, and now India and Pakistan as well. So these are the members of Shanghai Cooperation Organization. There is one country of Central Asia which is not a part. Now you always establish, you always will have a link between these countries whenever we try to remember their capitals. Or you try to remember their currencies, you all remember them together. So Turkmenistan is the country which is not a part of SCO. Just remember it like this. Other all the stands of Central Asia are part of SCO apart from Turkmenistan. They are not a part of Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Moving on, question number 17. Which village of Karnataka has become the first village to have 100% solar powered houses? This is Amasibailu. Amasibailu is the first village which has 100% solar powered houses. This is situated in Udupi district. Udupi district of Karnataka. Remember the name of the district as well. So it has lots of solar lights. There are more than 1800 houses that are lit by solar powered lights. The first programming language was Fortran. Fortran stands for formula translation. It stands for formula translation. Fortran was invented by IBM and the team was led by a scientist called John Backus. So John Backus at IBM was the creator of this formula translation Fortran language. So this was widely used to have a high level general purpose programming, to do high level general purpose programming. But now there are many other languages, but it is still a popular language for high performance computing. Okay, remember this, Fortran. Which is the largest internal organ in the human body? Read very carefully, internal organ. We are talking about only internal organ. So the largest internal organ is liver. Liver is also the heaviest internal organ. But if I ask you what is the largest organ in the human body, that will be the skin. The entire skin acts as one organ, so it is the largest organ, but it is an external organ. Alright, so it will be an external organ, the skin. Last question for today. Deloonyx regia raffin is the scientific name of which tree? So it is the gulmohar. Gulmohar is the scientific name of gulmohar is Deloonyx regia raffin, and it is part of family Fabaceae of the flowering plants. Thank you very much for watching this. Have a great day.